Hi everyone, today is Thursday, October 5th, 2017, and welcome to vlog number, four. Vlog number four, The Crunch.
Thursdays, I eat hotcakes.
So what is the crunch? Now, I've explained the crunch a little bit before as far as what the workload was, but the crunch is what I refer to when all Brite work comes in due around the same time. So I'm in this time period, which is the last part of the semester before fall break, was where I had three papers due in 8 days. And the first paper was due 2 days ago on Tuesday, and I finished that shit last week on Thursday. But now what I'm looking at is that I have a paper due, a 7-page exegesis paper due on Tuesday, and then I have a 5 to 7 page paper due on a spiritual figure on Wednesday. And not only that, I realized earlier this week, that I have a test Thursday afternoon in Intro to Theology. So that's what I'm calling the crunch, because all this stuff is lined up to where I have these three huge things due within 24 hours. How does that always happen here? What are we doing? Are these professors getting together and like holding like conferences and trying to line everything up to torture us, or is all this merely coincidental? Logic tells you that it can't be coincidental, but this is Brite, where nothing is really logical and nothing is really how you think it's going to be. So, is all this just coincidence? If it is, then we need to start planning a little bit better, because this shit is crazy. Everyone has been on edge for the last 2 weeks. Just you can just feel the tension. You can just feel the exhausted in the room. It gets to be an exhausting place to be around. And I wasn't really falling victim to it until the last 2 days. In the last 2 days, I have just been totally off. It's been showing in my diet, it's been showing in my workouts. I have just been off of my game. And I need to pick it up, because the crunch is here, and I can't afford to perform subparly. So that's where we are right now as far as the crunch goes. Today's Thursday, like I said. I'm probably not gonna check in too much today, but it's going to be a long, it's going to be quite a journey until we get to next Wednesday. It is Saturday, it's about 12:30, and damn, it's a lot going on today, and a lot of the things that I can't do because of the crutch. Last few days I've been doing a lot of reading and preparing for papers. I've been trying to study for the test, but I still got a lot of writing to do and not a lot of time to do it. And today so much is going on. In just a couple of hours, TCU is playing West Virginia, and it's one of the biggest games going on in the country right now. I mean, College Game Day was, as you see in some of those things I shot, College Game Day was here today in Fort Worth. And, I mean, I was asleep the whole time. But I don't know if I would have gotten, even if I didn't, would have been in the crunch, because it's Saturday and I want to sleep. But but there's a lot going on, and Fort Worth Pride is today. And most of Brite people are marching in the Pride Parade in downtown Fort Worth today, and I really hate that I'm not there with them. And it's just a lot going on. And I have friends in town, and I mean they're off doing stuff right now, but just a lot going on. A lot of things I'd rather be doing in the crunch, but this is part of life at Brite. Part of life at Brite is these crunches where everything is going on, and I just gotta get through it. I've got this afternoon, and I'm not going to the game, I'm not doing Pride, and I'm gonna try to work. So I'm gonna try to work on my spiritual life leadership paper today. That's the agenda for today. But that's where I'm at. I mean, the gym's closed anyways. I can't be, I mean, I had nothing else to do but to work right now. So, yeah, I'm going to eat some food. I'm going to eat some water. And then I'm going to write this paper. All right, it is Sunday, about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And I got a fair amount of work done today. I mean, yesterday. Got a fair amount of work done yesterday. Didn't have a lot of time. There's a lot going on. I had friends in the area. Just lots of stuff happening. But I did get some pretty good work done. Got all my terms for my test on Tuesday, all color-coded and everything in really nice gel ink. And I got halfway through another paper, but the big exegesis one is one that I still haven't done a lot of work on. And that's what we're going to be doing today and probably tomorrow. And we're probably, I shudder thinking how late I'm going to be up the next 2 nights, but it's what we got to do. It's what we left. My eyes already look terrible. They're going to look even worse over the next couple days. So, I mean, let's go, man.
Like a perfect night to dress up like hipsters and make fun of our exes. It feels like a perfect night for breakfast at midnight to fall in love with strangers. Yeah, we're happy, free, confused, and lonely at the same time. It's miserable and magical. The deadlines, it's time. Uh-oh, I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Everything will be alright if you keep me next to you. You don't know about me, but I'll bet you want to. Everything will be alright if we just keep dancing like we're 22.
This is the graduate reading room at Brite in the TCU library. This is where, this is where a lot of sausage gets made on the Brite campus as far as papers being written and assignments that get done. All these shelves are, this is basically the Brite library where we can go and find stuff whenever we need it. And, I have spent some long hours in this room and I think I'm gonna have some tonight.
'Cause that winter was long, but by dawn you were gone. I'll be okay.
About midnight, and I've actually gotten a lot of really good work done. I am almost as surprised as anybody probably would be, but I got here about 9, and I have about three and a half pages done of what's supposed to be a 6 to 7 page paper. So in about 3 hours, I got about halfway done, and hell yeah. I think that's pretty good work. I feel like the paper's going pretty well. I feel like, I don't know, everyone has been panicking over this exegesis paper. It's one of those things where, like, when so many people panic about something, you feel like you should panic too, even though you feel like you understand what's going on. So it's kind of a mind, it's just such a trip sometimes because you let other people's expectations of what other people experience kind of dictate what you're doing. And that is not me at all. That's not what I want to do. That's not what I want to accomplish. So the fact that I've gotten through in 3 hours half this paper and I really like what I'm doing and I'm really feel like I'm on the right path, it's got me a little, feel like I should be flustered, but at the same time, I know I'm doing good work. So, I'm going to head back to my apartment and maybe try to get some work done before I go to bed and try to get up a little bit earlier than I expected tomorrow. Because honestly, I expected to be here until 6 a.m. pretty much.
but I feel like I've done some really good work so far, so I can go home and maybe go to bed early and get an early start and have this done sometime before tomorrow evening. That way I'm not up all night tomorrow. I mean, I really thought I would be up all night tonight and up all night tomorrow, or one or the other, but I feel like now that's the possibility that doesn't have to happen. So I'm going to go home, I'm going to leave this wonderful reading room, which I love, and I don't know. We'll see.
All right, it is 12:30. It is 12:30 a.m. on Monday night, and my exegesis paper is done! Yes! Okay, anyways, yes, finished up my exegesis paper about an hour ago, and really didn't take me near as long as I thought. I sincerely thought that I would be up for till 6 a.m., you know, working on this paper, making sure that it was done, but, you know, I worked for 3 hours last night, and I worked for about 4.5 hours tonight, and that was enough to get it done. And I think it's a pretty good paper. Not the best thing that I've ever done, but it's actually really, really good and really, really quality. And I'm really happy about that. So that's two down, one to go. The last thing I have left is my spiritual life and leadership paper, which is due on Wednesday morning. And I'm a little more than half done with that. So that's another night in the stupid reading room. But hey, we'll get it done. And then we have a test tomorrow afternoon at 5. So most of the morning and the afternoon I'll probably be devoted to that. But we're getting through this. We are surviving the crunch. And also, a cold front just hit Fort Worth. So it's not going to be 90 degrees anymore. It's about 65 degrees right now. It's actually cold outside. So things are changing here in Fort Worth. And I'm pretty darn happy right now. So I'm going to look over these terms for this test, and then I'm going to go to sleep. But that's all for now. All right, it is about 7:30 on Tuesday night, 10:10. And, okay, so the test was done, and it was, I either did really, really well, or I completely crapped the bed. There was no in-between with that test. Wording was really complicated, but, I felt reasonably well prepared, and a lot of it was just, okay, what is actually being said in this answer? It was, not straightforward, despite the professor's best professions that it was. So we've got one more assignment, sort of, and that is my spiritual life and leadership paper over Howard Thurman. And I'm about 3 pages into what has to be 5 to 7 pages, probably one of it being 7 pages, but and I'm gonna go and put in this work. But unlike the exegesis paper, my spiritual life and leadership paper in Howard Thurman is something I actually look forward to doing. I just wish I had infinite time to do it, but do this than I do, because I really am enjoying it. So that's the difference between this one and that assignment. But we're gonna go do that, and we're in the final hours of the crunch, and we are surviving with minimal ulcers. So yeah. Okay, well, it's 5:15 in the morning. I am still wide awake, and I just now finished my spiritual life and leadership paper. It's submitted, it's off, and it's done. Damn, did it take a long time to get out. And here's the funniest thing: if you would have asked me a couple weeks ago before the crunch which assignment I felt best about, I would have told you this one. I would have told you, due to the way this paper was structured, and due to how I felt about the material, that this would have been the easiest paper. Yet I came into this paper with about 50% of it done, and I started working about 7:30 tonight, and I'm just now finishing at 5:15 a.m. And I don't know if I'm just breaking down and really need to rest. I don't know if I was putting too much pressure on myself to finish the paper, or I was just letting myself get too distracted, or what was going on. But this one was just a monster to do. To get the information that was in my head and in my heart onto the page was just was just really, really difficult, and I cannot tell you why. In the end, I felt like, you know, all right, camera died a little bit earlier, and that was like, that was about 30 minutes ago, and the camera died, and I'm still wide awake. That's the consequence of having adrenaline. But yeah, I didn't expect this to be my first all-nighter this semester, but I guess it officially is, but I guess that's what happens sometimes. Now, the fact that I was also watching 15 episodes of Dragon Ball at the same time probably has something to do with the all-nighter, but I digress. Anyways, this is kind of the end of the crunch. This is the last assignment of the crunch. I have class today. Don't know if I'll make that. And then I have my regular slate of class, my regular day on Thursday. But other than that, I mean, the semester's half over. Holy crap, man. But yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited for reading week next week. I'm excited to go home and visit my parents and see my friends. I'm excited to be somewhere other than here for a while. But at the same time, still a lot of work to be done. Still a semester to go. I'm excited about all that, and Roll Tide. I'm not an Alabama fan. It's a whole thing. I'll talk about it later. But I just want to say thank you for watching. Thank you for being with me through the crunch. And until then, take care and don't be a dick. I try to fight it, but every time it's like a brand new car or a drug, and you know you're gonna try it. When they tell you that you can't do that, but you will, and you know you're gonna like it.